As a new phase of a global campaign to advance the rights of transgender individuals, Filipino-American supermodel Geena Rocero says the key to her movement's success can start with a simple conversation. Don Tagala has this story.
Born with a DNA for great looks, flawless skin, an infectious smile, and a hot body fit for a supermodel, Geena Rocero made it in New York's fashion industry. Signed to Next Models, this Filipina beauty has worked for Rimmel Cosmetics, Hanes, and other fashion and beauty companies worldwide. But the Filipina supermodel kept a big part of her life a secret. Until her big reveal at the TED Talk in Vancouver, Canada recently.
I was assigned boy at birth based on the appearance of my genitalia. I remember when I was 5 years old in the Philippines walking around our house, I would always wear this t-shirt in my head. And my mom asked me, "How come you always wear that t-shirt in your head?" I said, "Mom, this is my hair. I'm a girl."
Born and raised in Guadalupe in Makati, she began competing in beauty pageants at the age of 15. She came to the U.S. when she was 17, and her modeling career began when she was discovered by a fashion photographer at a Lower East Side restaurant in New York at 21.
I felt like a girl, but nobody really knew what that was. I hope people will have the chance to better understand what that meant, because it's very important, you know, to show that sometimes our gender assignment at birth doesn't really match who we are.
For 9 years, Rocero says she had to keep her past a secret out of fear and shame. Globally, there is no universal right to change one's gender marker on identifying documents without having to undergo sex reassignment surgery.
It should be politically recognized. I think transgender people and gender variant people, like intersex people, should be allowed to change their name and gender marker in their documents without being forced to go through surgeries.
A transgender fashion model and activist, Rocero says coming out was not only life-changing and healing for herself, but it's also a chance to tell her powerful story to help other transgender people like her live life without fear and shame. Together with Gender Proud, an advocacy and awareness group she created to advance the rights of all transgender individuals, her next big step is to advocate for policy changes around the world that would fight for transgender rights and equality.
As much as I talk about policy and progressive approach into how we could make change, I'm also a storyteller. You know, I will use art in any way I can to change the world, to tell this story, because at the end of the day, art really, you know, breaks down the barrier, and it really leaves people to understand better. It opens up conversations.
Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.